Hi, this is Listen to Your Mind's Heart, a system for effective music generation by a brain-computer interface. I am Marco Tiraboschi from the Music Informatics Laboratory at University of Milan. The goal of our system was to take in EEG data and to estimate the emotion of a user to generate music that reflects that emotion. We designed this system in four different modules. The first module is the EEG affect recognition module. It is responsible for taking in EEG data and outputting a classification of the user's affective state. We defined the user's affective state as the combination of its valence and arousal values. Valence refers to the user's affective state as being negative or positive. Negative could be sad, and positive could be happy. Arousal refers to the activation of the user's emotion. A low arousal could be calm, and a high arousal could be rage. So we have a total of four different possible affective states, because both are modeled as binary variables. We used the deep dataset to benchmark several machine learning algorithms from the state of the art. We divided the dataset in two parts. We used the first part of the dataset to determine which algorithm worked best. We used the second part of the dataset to evaluate how well the algorithm worked. At the beginning, we used all the 32 EEG channels available in the deep dataset. And we found out that with a super vector machine with a polynomial kernel, we found similar results as the one described in the deep dataset paper. But then we asked ourselves, can't we use fewer than 32 channels for the classification? Using fewer channels means that we can have an EEG headset with fewer electrodes. It means that the EEG headset is cheaper and quicker to install. So we tried with 6 EEG channels, and we also used just the frequency bands that are more reliable. Low frequencies are influenced by muscle noise, so noise from the muscle in the user face, and high frequencies can sometimes be influenced by the power line interference. And we found out that with a naive bass, we could get almost the same results. So with the full feature set, we had a 62% F-score for valence and a 56% F-score for arousal classification. With only 6 channels and 3 frequency bands, we had 60% F-score of valence and 55% F-score for arousal. So it is a reduction of one order of magnitude from the number of features, so this is a significant result. Then we also tried to use a dataset made with just 2 EEG channels. And we found out that with all frequency bands, we can still classify valence and arousal, but with just the 3 central frequency bands, we were not able to classify arousal because the performance was not significantly different from a random predictor. So we then designed a 6-channel brain-computer interface. We used hardware from GTEC, and then we used the OpenVibe environment to develop the software. This environment is very convenient because it allows to develop software that is independent from the specific EEG headset. In OpenVibe, we program the feature extraction component of the software. And then we also use the OpenVibe to communicate those features via OSC. Then we designed the online music generation module. This module generates music in real time and also allows to change the characteristics of the music in real time. If the user's emotion changes, we want to be able to change the characteristics of the music to match that change in the emotion. We started with the music VAE model. This is an artificial neural network by Google's Magenta project, and pre-trained models are available for this. We are interested in the decoder network, so the music generating part of the network. It is our current neural network, and it can run for how long we want, and this is a positive. but it has one major downside, that is that we can only specify the features of the music once. But we wanted to be able to change these features when the user's emotion changed. So we made a modification to this model. Every so often, we can interpolate the current state with the network with a new state, computing started with a different feature vector. In this way, we can change the music characteristics in real time while the model is generating the music. But now there is one more problem. We don't know what the music VAE features represent. So we need a model that allows us to map the emotion to the music VAE latent space. So we designed a musical affect model using a probabilistic graphical model. This graph represents the stochastic variables that are in our system. We have a variable at the bottom of the graph on the left that is called M. M is the variable that represents the MIDI file that is output from the model. Z is the vector of music VAE latent variables, and we know that they are distributed as a Gaussian because of how music VAE is trained. We want this variable Z to depend on the arousal value and valence value. So we will say that the mean and the precision of the Gaussian distribution of Z are dependent on the arousal and valence values. Arousal and valence can only assume binary values, so we model them as Bernoulli variables, and they depend only on their probability parameter that is distributed as a beta distribution. Then we simplify this model. We don't actually need the probability parameters of arousal and valence, so we remove them from the model, and no modification was needed. But to remove the mean and precision variables, we had to change the model a little, because the distribution of a Gaussian variable whose mean and precision are distributed as a normal Wishart is a multivariate T. So in our simplified model on the right, Z is actually distributed as a T distribution. But now we had a problem. To learn the conditional probabilities in this model, we had a dataset of only 150 examples. To learn the covariance matrix or the scale matrix of a T distribution, we need at least a number of samples equal the dimension of the variable. Z is a vector of 512 values, and we didn't have 512 examples in our dataset. A first approach to simplify this model was to use a naive-based assumption. So we could say the scale matrix of the T distribution is diagonal, so we don't have the problem of dimensionality. Another approach was to use principal component analysis. So we introduced a new latent variable that we will call H. Principal component analysis assumes that this hidden variable H is distributed as a Gaussian, and our observed variable is actually a linear function of H plus some noise. We can assume that all data in our dataset is distributed in a subspace of Z, and so we can learn the PPCAs on the entire dataset, and these results in the graph on the left. Another way of applying PPCA results in the graph on the right. Now we are assuming that for every affective state, the data points belonging to that state are distributed in a different subspace of the variable Z. The learning problem is to learn different PPCA for every one of the four different affective states. This is the approach that we use to actually produce some examples. You can find them at the link that is displayed on the slides and is also referenced in the paper. To recap now, I will show you a diagram of the entire system. The user brain activity is captured with the EEG hardware. The raw EEG data is then sent to OpenVibe. OpenVibe, we are performing the feature extraction, and we are sending the features via OSC to our Python application. Our Python application runs an OSC server to receive those features and uses the EEG features to recognize the user's affective state. Then it maps the user's affective state to music VAE latent features. The feature vector is then input to USB, and the MIDI is then sent to a MIDI sequencer so that the user can then hear the generated music in real time. So thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, please ask them in the Q&A later.